We will take questions in Chinese or in English. Please use the Zoom hand raise feature to queue yourself in line for a question, and we will call on you, or you may type your question in chat to be read out loud. First question. Mize Esports 369. What, in your opinion, was the most difficult this series? Did you expect G2 to perform at this level?
小麦三六选手，在这个系列赛里边，你觉得可能让你们感受到最困难的点是什么？然后你们之前有预料到可能 G2 他们今天的竞技水平在就是这么高的一个水平上面吗？
就觉得 G2 的找机会能力比较强吧，然后给到我们很大困扰，然后我们在面对 G2 的时候也比较着急。哦，这样。
So firstly, what G2 did is really they found a lot of chance to make the engagement on this series. And also on our end, we are definitely too rushed to do, make some decisions. So yeah, they are the stronger side of this series.
Next question from Game K. There is an opinion that your jungle and bot lane didn't have good coordination today. What do you think about this?
小麦三六的选手就是有些观点认为你们今天下路和打野的配合可能出现一点问题，你是怎么看这个观点的？
就是我们比较急吧，然后主要这样吧。
Yeah, we are just too rush to make some decision.
Next question from Lag Vietnam.Your journey with TESS at MSI 2024 has concluded with many memories and lessons learned. Based on this experience, what are the team's goals for the summer split of LPL, especially with many significant changes ahead for the tournament?
想问一下三六九选手，其实对于整个滔博来讲，整个MSI 的旅程就画上句号了嘛？那对于你们来讲，在整个这个这个赛事当中学到了什么？然后以及你们对于未来，因为夏季赛 LPL 也有一些这个赛制上的改变嘛，那你们对于新的赛季是有怎样的展望和目标呢？
对于新的赛季的话，我们就想着还是就争取拿到最好的成绩嘛。然后在 MSI 的话也是学到了很多和其他赛区较少的经验嘛。
For this MSI, we learned a lot from playing against teams from other regions. Yeah, we definitely learned a lot from it. And for the new season, we will try our best to get good results.
Next question, Hupu.
Hupu 的提问是会怎么评价自己回归滔博之后的这个赛季？
就感觉就是还得就是再玩得好一点，然后就这样。
Next question from Pedro Romero. Commiserations on the loss. Broken Blade stood out today in the series for G2 by having a great performance in Game 1 and Game 3. What was the biggest obstacle you saw in facing him today?
其实也很遗憾今天没有能够更进一步嘛。想问一下在这个系列赛当中，其实无论三九选手还是 Broken Blade 选手在第一局和第三局其实表现都还是不错的，所以想问一下今天三六九选手面对到 Broken Blade 的选手当中觉得他就是最困难面对他最困难的一点是什么？
我感受下来的话，我就觉得他比我更有耐心吧，就这样。
He is more patient than me on this series. That's it.
Next question from Ashley King.After today's series, should we consider G2 as a contender to win MSI? Do you think G2 has the capability?
在今天的这个系列赛之后，我们是否可以觉得G2 也是 MSI 冠军的有力争夺者？然后你觉得G2 有这样的能力吗？
我觉得就从G2 打了比赛看下来，就是他们也是实力非常强劲的，然后他们状态好的话也是有机会夺冠。
As far as we can see, what G2 performance on this tournament, yeah, they are capable to be the contender of the MSI championship if they are in a very good form.
Next question from Cloud Sidkey. Do you think G2 played differently compared to what they showed previously? And did that catch Tess off guard?
你觉得今天 G2 整体在比赛过程中展现的相比于他们之前展现的是不是有很大的不同？是不是在这些不同上面让你们就是出乎意料，或者是或者换个说法，就是让你们没有了防备？
我觉得 G2 的话，他们游戏风格都是之前一样的吧，然后我觉得是我们自己的问题。
I think what G2 did today, just follow their play style. Actually, the main problem is what we performance, are not good on today.
Next question from Pedro Romero. Obviously, losing to G2 this early in the lower bracket is not what you expected. What is one thing you feel the team could have done differently this tournament?
因为输给 G2 止步现在这个阶段对于你们来说可能觉得也是没有达到预期的嘛，所以想问一下你觉得就是今天就在这整个比赛当中你有哪些地方你觉得是可以就是改进的或者做的不一样一点？
我个人的话就是我认为我其实第三局的发挥不是很好，然后当时心里面比较着急，然后也给了很多机会，我觉得很后悔吧，就是如果不给那些机会的话，我们说不定还能找人追赛。
Personally, for this series on match three, I was too rushed to bring back strong team, so I made some mistake on that matches. So I'm really sorry for that. If I can do not make that much mistakes, maybe we can make the reverse sweep.
Next question, Hoopoo.
下一个问题想问一下，因为接下来 BLG 将面对LCK 的队伍和 G2 嘛，有没有为就是其他的队友其他的 BLG 的队员加油的话，带他兵啊？
最后希望就 BLG 的哥几个就好好打吧，然后拿下冠军。
Next question, OnePlus.
今天赛前做了哪些准备？然后在比赛中有哪些意料之外的情况发生呢？
比赛赛前的话就是我们就是尽量就是不去被G2的游戏风格影响到嘛，然后意外的话就是可能就是还是有点急，就被他们带入他们的节奏了吧。
And last question, eSports Focus.
大电竞的问题想问一下，为什么最后两局依然放出了小炮给到对面？
这个主要还是看就大家我想一下。这个其实主要就是讨论下来的结果吧。
All right.
That's everything.
Thank you.